We're all held together by cells, but we're also surrounded by skin. We're surrounded by soft materials, and they hold all these cells together. And it's the interaction between these cells and these materials which fascinates me. My name's Alan Rowan. I am a professor of physical chemistry. I've been a scientist all my life, since I was 17 years old. A few years ago, I moved to Australia as director of the AIBN, but also have a research group where what we actually do is we look at trying to mimic the materials in the human body. In my group, I have some amazing biologists who know and understand how cells work. I have some amazing polymer and chemistry people who can make polymers of different types and structures. Then I have a whole cohort of physicists and optical spectroscopists who design machines so we can actually look at these materials in real time and see how they interact with cells. And so I've been very fortunate to build this team where we design new materials which try and mimic the natural materials in the human body and then try and look at how they interact with cells. And you'll go, well, is that important or not? Well, actually, it turns out lots of diseases we have are because of these interactions going wrong between cells and materials. So we grow these materials and then grow cells. We can grow mini organs in these materials. We can modify cells to see how does it work. We use it to try and make materials to make wounds heal quicker without scarring. We design materials so we can actually control the bone so that you actually get bone formation correctly in osteoporosis or prevent bone formation in arthritis. We look at the fundamental aspects of how cells talk to your soft materials, and then we try and tune the cells to do the right thing. I was working on some polymer materials which went into banknotes so that people couldn't forge them. So we had to make them to dissolve in water, and we made this material, and then all of a sudden something was really strange. We found that they wouldn't dissolve in water unless we put it in the fridge. So they dissolve when they're cold, but when you warm it up, they become solids, which is like the reverse way. And that was one of those like childlike moments where you go, that's strange. And it turned out that these materials mimic the collagens and fibrins in your body perfectly. They're almost like a perfect mimic of the mechanics and how they behave. This is really useful. We can make new materials which are like wounds. We can make new materials for growing cells. When you cut yourself, you put a pad on there to stop it bleeding. That takes about 5 minutes for the scar to form. We can do it in 30 seconds. These are the things we're working on. That's what's exciting about it. We're at this interface doing really creative science.